ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما يا أرحم الراحمين. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal teach us what benefit us from what you taught us and increase us in knowledge. My dear beloved brothers and sisters, I ask Allah Azza wa Jal to protect you from any harm. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed many books and the meanings of all the ayat in these books is summarized in the Quran. And the meaning of the whole Quran is summarized in the Fatiha. And the meaning of the Fatiha is summarized in Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in. And now we are there. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. الله أكبر. يا الله, you alone we worship and you alone we ask for help. So my brothers and sisters, after we recounting Allah's majesty and expressing Allah's mercy, and after realizing that we are definitely going back to Allah Azza wa Jal, now this ayah brings the essence of what we are supposed to be doing in this dunya. What is the purpose of our existence is in this ayah we are about to recite. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. وتقديم العبادة على الاستعانة في الفاتحة من باب تقديم الغايات على الوسائل. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put first the ibadah, إياك نعبد, before إياك نستعين, because the ibadah is the goal. Ibadah, worshipping Allah Azza wa Jal, is the goal of our life, is the reason for our existence. And إياك نستعين, seeking help, is the means to get to the goal why we are in this dunya. So we cannot put the means before the goal. The goal is to worship Allah Azza wa Jal, and the only way to be able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with his help. Subhanallah. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said that he heard his teacher Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah say, Iyaka na'budu, إياك نعبد gets rid of رياء, showing off. And إياك نستعين gets rid of arrogance. إياك نعبد, يا الله, I sincerely worship you. Sincerely you and you alone. No رياء. وإياك نستعين, I am admitting, يا الله, that I cannot do it on my own. I need your help. That means there's no arrogance right there. Subhanallah. So, we discussed before when we were talking about the adhan that the two conditions for any action, any ibadah to be accepted, number one, it has to be done sincerely for the sake of Allah, and number two, it has to be done according to the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we said that they both have to be combined for the amal to be accepted. طيب. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين? Because if you take it linguistically, we should have said نعبدك ونستعين بك. We worship you and we seek your help. Subhanallah. There's a huge difference. When we say نعبدك, that means I worship you and maybe also I worship somebody else. And when I say نستعين بك, I seek your help and I seek his help and I seek her help, I might be also asking someone else's help. But when I say, إياك نعبد, يا الله, you are the only one I worship, the only one who deserves to be worshipped, and the only one that I seek help from is you, يا الله, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah, how eloquent is the Quran. It is you I worship. Iyyaka na'budu. This is the core of sincerity. It is the core of ikhlas. Without ikhlas, my brothers and sisters, all our a'mal will be multiplied by zero. All our a'mal, no matter how big it is, it will be multiplied by zero. Ikhlas is the essence of our ibadat. It has to be done sincerely for the sake of Allah. So, let me ask you a question. And this problem, many of us, or if not all of us, we fell sometimes into this problem, into this trap. When we do something good, do we expect praise from people? When I do someone a favor, am I sitting and waiting down? I'm waiting for him to say, thank you, you have been so good to me, you have saved my life. Am I waiting for it? Do we wait for it? Or do we become bothered if they do not say it? How many times some of us say, look what he has done to me after all I have done to him, right, or to her. We say this statement sometimes. When we say these things, that means the amal was not done for Allah alone, right? If it was done sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, listen carefully, my brothers and sisters, this is for the salat and this is for all our life. When we do a'mal to others, make sure you're doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not wait for the thank you. If the thank you comes, that's a bonus. The thank you is a bonus, okay? I'm not expecting the thank you. And of course, the person should say thank you, because Rasulullah ﷺ told us, whomsoever does not thank the people, does not thank Allah Azza wa Jal. But I'm not expecting the thank you. I'm not looking for the thank you. If it comes, alhamdulillah. If it does not come, alhamdulillah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Al-Insan, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَىٰ حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. And they feed the miskin, the poor, and they feed the orphan, and they feed the captive of war, even though they love that food, they need it themselves, but they're giving it to others. And what did he say after that?
إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ لا نريد منكم جزاء ولا شكورا.
We are only feeding you for the sake of Allah, for the pleasure of Allah. We do not want anything in return from you. We do not even want a thank you. Allahu Akbar. So, when we do a'mal, we have to do them for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I am doing this in order to gain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is all I care about. This is my main concern. If the person acknowledges it and thank me, alhamdulillah. But my goal is to please him. And if he sees the sincerity in my amal, it is registered already. It is registered. Allahu Akbar. So we have to be very careful. For example, if people think that you are truthful, because what other people think does not really matter. If all people think that you are truthful and kind and loving and caring, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows otherwise, does it matter what the people think? Nope. If you are a very rich person, and the people start saying, he's poor, he's not really that rich, he is in debt, does that decrease your amount of wealth? No. Don't worry about the people. Worry about the Rabb of the people. Don't worry about the people. Worry about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will never be able to please the people. So what is the cure? To always revise your intention and rectify it. And try, listen carefully please, try to have some a'mal, some actions that are only known to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You sponsor an orphan and no one knows about it. You sponsor a widow and no one knows about it. You get up in the middle of the night and you pray 2 rak'ah and no one knows about it. Subhanallah. This is sincerity. This is showing that, Ya Allah, all I care about is your pleasure. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. Revive that feeling. Ya Allah, I'm praying this salat because this is my role in this dunya. This is my purpose in this dunya, is to worship you. And Ya Allah, there's no way I can do it without your help. Some people, unfortunately, we grew up in our cultures, in many societies, we grew up on riya. We grew up on showing off. We were told, right? We were told, or sometimes we tell our children, don't do this. How dare you do this? What would the people say about us? Right? How many times this happened? What would the people say about you? We insert that, or we instill that in our children's minds and hearts, and that will make them, all they worry about is the people, and they forget that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one to worry about. Aib, like in the Arab word, aib, no, this is a shame to do this. No. We have to tell them that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching. Allah will not be happy with this action. Allah will not be happy to see you at this place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not the people, subhanallah. So our biggest problem is that we grew up on this. And sometimes even the riya, we do riya, we do showing off, not any, we feel that riya when we are alone. How can someone have riya when he's alone or when she is alone? Have you ever been sometimes praying qiyam at night by yourself and you start shedding some tears? So you pray in qiyam at night and you start shedding some tears because you got, in the zone and you're enjoying those two rak'ahs and the tears start flowing. And you said to yourself, ah, I wish my wife would wake up and see those tears. I wish someone else could see these tears. Subhanallah, this is called al-riya al-khafi. You want to show off even though you're alone. Subhanallah. No, ya akhi, no. As a matter of fact, try to hide your amal from the people. Make sure that this amal is as secretive as possible. These are the amal that have more sincerity. We should try to wash our hearts with this ayah. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. It is you, Ya Allah. You, Ya Allah, alone. We ask for help. That shows our humility. The only way for the salat to touch us deeply is when we do it sincerely for the sake of Allah. And that's why we are saying, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. And the only way to be able to perform the ibadah is by Allah's help. So that's why we are saying, إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. Ya Allah, I need your help. Somebody might say, طيب, Allah did not guide me to this. Ask him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hadith al-Qudsi, he said, كُلُّكُمْ ضَالْ إِلَّا مَنْ هَدَيْتَ فَاسْتَهْدُونِي أَهْدِكُمْ. All of you are astray except the one I have guided. So ask me for guidance and I will guide you. Ask Allah to guide you. What's the next ayah? اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. Allahu Akbar. Look at the order. Subhanallah. First, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. What kind of Rabb is this? Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. مالك يوم الدين. The owner of يوم الدين is Rahman and Rahim. How can I be saved on يوم الدين? إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. By worshipping Allah, by only seeking His help. How can I seek His help? إهدنا الصراط المستقيم. That will be our ayah to be discussed tomorrow if Allah kept us alive, inshaAllah ta'ala. This is the first and most important dua in the Quran. Allahu Akbar. Tomorrow, bi-idhnillah ta'ala. So recite إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ very slowly and wait for the answer of Allah. Remember, we said Allah answers you back after every single ayah of the Fatiha. What does Allah answer when I say, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ? Slow down and enjoy when Allah says, هَذَا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ عَبْدِي وَلِعَبْدِي مَا سَأَلْ. This is between me and my servant, and my servant will receive whatever he or she asks for. Slow down and enjoy the response from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah bless you and protect you. May Allah fill your homes with love and mercy and tranquility. May Allah make us from the people who have khushu' in their salat. May Allah azza wa jal make our last deeds our best deeds. آمين يا رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك See you all tomorrow إن شاء الله
شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون.